From having to close shop due to the pandemic, only to reopen to a barrage of refund demands and not enough bookings, 2020 was indeed a challenging year for travel agencies and the tourism sector as a whole. Despite lingering virus fears and the quarantine measures that remain in place, the Philippine Travel Agencies Association believes a recovery is possible in the first quarter of 2021, buoyed by the reopening of several local destinations like Boracay, Siargao, and Batangas. The PTAA is also pushing through with its 28th Travel Tour Expo in May to serve as another springboard to the revival of Philippine tourism. For more on this, we're joined by former PTAA President Eileen Clemente.
So I just like to start out by asking, how are these lockdowns making it travel and tourism in the country?
Actually, the really biggest difficulty in promoting travel and tourism is the fact that there is no concerted effort among the different LGUs. So that's what's travelers not confident in how to travel. Even in the form of testing, it's different. Having quarantines is another thing. In fact, under the World Travel and Tourism Council, under all the different associations that are global, we are all pushing for no quarantine, but pre-testing, pre-departure. So this is more of the way that people should be traveling. Before you spread it, you have to be proactive in how to test the people prior to traveling instead of waiting to come to the destination and go on a quarantine.
Would you say that the requirements here in the Philippines are stricter compared to other countries?
We are actually the only country requiring face shield. but again, it serves its purpose. But again, if I will say it, we require face shields, but we're not stopping, say, something like as basic as spitting. Spitting is still being done. So, I mean, very basic, but, you know, these are things that cause contamination. We're trying to let people think that there should be no contamination, but the implementation is not happening.
Right now, it's only February, but I'm just wondering, are we already seeing a more robust travel happening domestically compared to last year? Are we seeing, for example, an improvement compared to the fourth quarter and the third quarter?
Well, there are already travel bubbles, no? But they're still not as effective as you would want them to be. You may want to travel, but the frequency of flights is no longer there because people have been let go by their respective companies, especially the airlines. So because there is no concrete plan and every plan changes every 14 days, if I may say, that's what's causing this. Because if we make it more predictable or, you know, putting a real time limit na, oh, by this time we are able to do this already, we can move this to the next phase, instead of getting a surprise announcement every 14 days, it makes it more predictive. If you give a stability to that, people will be more encouraged to make their bookings already. Otherwise, they know that they may have to cancel, they have to watch out for something before they continue with their booking. So they can only do it within a window of 14 days.
So we're seeing big players like Shangri-La, for example, temporarily winding down. What are the implications of this as far as travel is concerned?
Again, it's a mobility issue, no? The more that we are not clear on our rules in how we are setting up the different protocols, you will expect that people will not go out, will not travel properly, again, following the protocol, the proper protocols, no? So every business will fall. I mean, all of us have already let go of a lot of our people, not just Shangri-La. Even Philippine Airlines has again announced they're letting go of more people. That will just be happening. More of that will be happening unless we have a predictive, as I mentioned, predictive way of dealing with this pandemic, how we are moving forward. There are already, as I said, global protocols that are being followed everywhere. Why isn't it that Philippines cannot mandate each and every LGU to follow the same global protocols?
Would you know how other countries are doing if travel there is performing better than it is in the Philippines?
Well, we all have our different situations. For example, the others, they say they're already on their third wave. Other countries never had a second wave. Portugal is one of them. They just practice the correct protocols. We have a lot of examples of the different countries in the way they are handling their protocols. But most of all of them are really into the fact that mobility should start happening. Otherwise, people will not die of the pandemic, but will die of economics. So there has to be that balance. The UAE, Turkey, and other countries are already opening up. They're very open, but they have very strict protocols also. Israel is also open. The Caribbean is Caribbean islands are also open. They have different status also, because even if UK has their third wave, they also have the funds to get their vaccines ahead of time. So their recovery period will be shorter than ours, definitely. So how do we do it? We just have to really practice the correct protocols, but uniformly.
We recently had this news about the three tourists in Boracay who tested positive for COVID-19 after presenting fake tests, no? So how can we prevent similar incidents from happening in the future?
Well, right now, the Philippines is not a signatory to the IATA pass or any of the other pass that are more credible. There are already passes that are credible and are accepted worldwide. Right now, it's just really a presentation of any document that says they are okay, any certification that are okay. But again, if you go through the things like IATA pass, then that makes it more credible. So what you also need to do is look for those that are credible sources of testings.
Whether being vaccinated is going to be one of the prerequisites of being allowed to travel overseas in the future.
Well, that's one of the things that the World Travel and Tourism Council is not into, no, because it's a discriminatory measure. Not everyone accepts vaccines anyway. They may have an easier time crossing borders, but they should not be a discriminatory measure for traveling. What we are saying is that they may have an easier time, but testing should be testing prior to departure should be another means that will allow travel. So our bottom line is allow mobility with proper protocols or proper vaccination and proper protocols.
Now, moving on to the local players, is the PTAA doing something to help these struggling local players? Because, I mean, we've been locked down for quite a bit, so I'm sure business has been bad and their resources might be running out.
Well, right now, PTAA just underwent a change of officers. But I know that the PTAA is already doing a lot of different things, like having position papers for presentation, as well as partnerships, including that of Red Cross and some other entities that will make or that can allow the leveraging of the number of travel agents that are still remaining to have a better leverage on certain pricing of certain testings or certain vaccines and so on.
So I just read that the PTAA is pushing through with the 28th Travel Tour Expo in May. So I'm just curious how the preparations are going on for this expo.
Well, we already have a few sponsors lined up. Already they have committed to us. So there are already a lot of sponsors and a lot actually are looking back on having a face-to-face, but both the Travel Tour Expo and the International Travel Tour Expo are going to be a hybrid. So for those who are not comfortable, we still have an avenue for them, but we also have an avenue for those who want to be physically present. Our prediction is that in Q3, people will already start traveling because I think there will be a better stability, or at least in Q3, they'll start booking. That's a global accepted fact that Q3 is the time that people will start booking and traveling.
Okay, with that, thank you very much and good luck to your expo in May.
Thank you.